Let's do some drywall.
Hey, YouTuber, do-it-yourselfer drywallers. Today we're doing a medicine cabinet fill-in on a vanity bathroom wall. This is the most common drywall repair I do in bathrooms. A lot of people like to remove that old medicine cabinet and have a nice flush wall so they can do a picture hanging mirror. A simple update to do on a bathroom, simple one wall repair like this, will make a big improvement on any bathroom. But here they had a couple patches from moving the electrical. They're just trying to line everything up. They had a medicine cabinet and then to the right of it a mirror, so it's a very goofy design. I'm just going through, put down some plastic to catch my mess, scrape the areas. Where the medicine cabinet was, I'm cutting it back about half an inch past the stud so I have something to screw the new sheetrock to. If you don't cut it back like this, then you're going to have to add framing, so sometimes it's better to cut from back. As you can tell in this little patch what I'm doing here, cutting it back half inch. Always scrape your areas. Once I'm ready to get some framing in, I like to use 1x2s. 1x2s are always a go-to. 1x2s, 2x2s, 2x4s. So you always use what's easiest. You want to always get extra backing in patches. That way the sheetrock can be screwed to each side. Here they kept the two patches they cut out for the running the electrical. The electrician was nice enough to keep these. Sometimes they don't keep these, so you'd have to cut new pieces. At least on these two pieces, I kept them. While I'm on the ladder, I'm going to fiberglass everything, scrape everything, and use fiberglass mesh tape on the patches. Since I'm already on the ladder, I'm going to do as much as I can on the ladder before I move to do my next. Right here's a patch. They didn't keep the piece. I'm just using a scrap piece of sheetrock, cutting it to size, little 3-inch by 3-inch hole. Get it in place, nice and tight. Add a couple screws, always add at least 2 or 3 screws to every patch. Same thing, scrape it up. And take your fiberglass mesh tape. I always use fiberglass mesh tape on drywall repairs. It's easier to work with, it's stronger material. Any little holes you see, little holes, always put a piece of fiberglass right over it. Scrape your areas. Basically, you want to scrape and prep your areas before you get any mud process. Once you get the sheetrock cut down, you can rasp the sides. If you don't have a rasp, then just cut it back with a razor blade just to make sure it's a nice fit. Once you get it fit to size, add some screws. Always add plenty of screws. Always add screws on the outside edge, old sheetrock, and add some screws on the new side of the sheetrock, as you can tell right here. Plenty of screws every 2 to 4 inches. I always recommend plenty of screws. It keeps it from cracking out. We don't want to do all this work and mud work and then it has cracks out later on. So that's why we add plenty of screws to resecure the old sheetrock. Scrape this real good. Always scrape your areas before you put your fiberglass mesh tape. On the top part, there's a little gap there. So I just double layered the fiberglass. Sometimes you can do 2 or 3 layers. It won't hurt. I'm using a 5-minute quick set mud. You can also use just a regular joint compound or a 20-minute or 40-minute or 90-minute. I'm using a 5-minute mud. I'm just mixing pan by pan. Put the pan on, clean it up. So it's easier on small jobs like this for me to work with 5-minute muds so I can get the mud on. I'm just getting the mud filled in on this, pushed in the fiberglass so it fills in the gaps. It's kind of like a pre-fill. You can also do this before your fiberglass. But now I'm just doing a nice heavy first coat. This is a 5-minute mud, so I'm working fast. You just get the materials on, do a nice clean first coat. You don't need to build up the mud really heavy. This is not like joint compound. Joint compounds you leave a little heavier because they shrink back. But with the hot muds, you just put them on because however you put them on is how it's going to stay. It doesn't shrink back. It's a quick setting material. It means there's chemical reaction makes it set up. This is a 5-minute mud, so it always sets up about 5 to 10 minutes. Once you get it start setting up after about 5 minutes or so, you take a wet sponge. And this is a slick out technique, a wet sponge with a 6-inch knife. You're just taking off the excess mud and kind of feathering it out, getting the excess mud. It's like a wet sanding. This is the technique you use with all hot muds. If anybody says you sand hot muds, they're lying to you. This is what you do with a 5-minute, 20-minute, 90-minute. You like to slick it out as it's setting up. You don't wait till it fully sets up. You catch it as it's setting up and you can work and manipulate the mud. Taking off the extra mud, it's a cleaner technique, a stronger material than regular joint compound. If you're not comfortable using hot muds, always use a joint compound. Now I'm just mixing a pan of second coat with 5-minute mud. It's about the same consistency as a first coat, but just a little bit thinner. So I just add like another ounce of water. If you put too much water, you can always dump some out. Mix it thoroughly, nice and creamy. Second coat, I'm taking it past my first coat, not putting it on really heavy. I'm just basically, it's like a skim coat over the first coat. This makes it nice and pretty and perfect. Always take your mud past your first coat mud. And I'm just going the opposite direction. Before I went up and down, now I'm going side to side. So that's a good fill-in technique, so you know you cross-fill it each way. Second coat setting up, different angle here. I'm just showing you how I'm slicking it out. Just working the mud, working it. Start at one part and just work it, work it, work it. Start at the top and bring it down. I'm basically working the materials like a wet sanding technique. Damp sponge, nice clean 6-inch, straight 6-inch knife. Any extra mud, you just scrape off your knife and throw it away. But basically you're manipulating the mud. As you can tell by I'm working the knife here, I'm just taking off the extra mud. No sanding involved, no dust involved when you use these hot muds. Drywall repairmen like myself that work in the field every day, we'd love these hot muds. Now I'm just using a red line mud. This is a red line mud, or you can use joint compound for the texture. This texture is called Santa Fe. It's like a smooth texture. It's not perfectly smooth. There's some skip trowel in it. It's a very common in the higher end homes here in Arizona where I'm working. So this is just Santa Fe. There's really nothing to it. You just put it on and slick it out almost. Here's a different angle. I'm just basically like putting it on almost like a skip trowel. Just nice and heavy, and then you just turn around and trowel it down. In Arizona, we have different categories of Santa Fe's. They call them a 90% Santa Fe, 98%. Basically, all that says it's 90% smooth, 10% skip trowel. So depending on how heavy or busy your walls, that kind of gives you the percentage. But that's just a gauge that they go off. Different areas have different textures.